In this video, I will test what are the most effective power upgrades for Marui HI-CAPAs. I'm comparing the stock gold match with 8 tiers of upgrades under standard conditions and analyzing the results statistically. There are so much subjective opinions on which are the best FPS upgrades. This video aims to address this issue by providing objective testing and ranking common upgrade parts based on their impact on muzzle velocity. It's measured in meters per second or FPS, and it's the most easily available metric for gun performance. However, it's not the only factor affecting performance. Good performing hop-up bucking is the most single important determinant of gun range, and some upgrade parts are not meant to affect the performance, but to make the vulnerable parts more durable. There are many ways to increase the FPS. Stronger gas would be an easy solution, sure, but gun parts will wear and break much faster. FPS upgrade parts primarily aim to improve air seal and to channel more efficiently kinetic energy to the BB. The results of this testing will be discussed in detail later in the video, but if you are on a budget, it's not required to spend huge amounts of money on FPS upgrades. Just get a longer inner barrel. This is simple physics. A longer barrel allows more time for the compressed gas to accelerate the BB before it exits the barrel. In a previous demonstration with a short HI-CAPA, a mere 1.8 cm increase in barrel length resulted in a significant 9% boost in FPS. All the tests were conducted in a normal room temperature using 0.2 gram dBs basic green gas. The magazine filled with gas always went out of BBs. The tested setups included the Marui gold match with a precision barrel only of a normal length, a longer 166 mm barrel left over from my Armorer Works gun, brass hop-up chamber by Maple Leaf, the chamber with bucking and a precision barrel, CowCow nozzle and blowback housing sets. All the previous with a normal length precision barrel. All the previous but with a 166 mm precision barrel and parts in Airsoft Masterpiece slide. The barrel tip just hidden inside a tracer. Having the hop-up on should have some effect on the FPS, so all testing was conducted, the hop-up turned off, although the distributions were quite overlapping when I tested with and without hop-up with the stock gold match. And remember, no money has exchanged hands, nor there was any sponsorship involved in this testing. The results for each setup are presented on a linear scale with meters per second. Viewers from the United States remember that 10 meters per second is roughly 33 FPS, and 100 meters per second is 330 FPS. The mean muzzle velocity is indicated by an arrow, and the range, or minimum and maximum values, are displayed within parentheses. So, is there a real difference of 3 meters per second between these two setups? Very likely no. It could well be attributed to random variation, and if the testing were repeated, the results could potentially be reversed. That's why I would define a minimally detectable change as a mean increase or decrease of at least 5 meters per second from the reference setup. Changes beyond this threshold are more likely real than just background noise due to random variation. And then the real thing. Real yet small changes in muzzle velocity are not necessarily noticeable during gameplay. That's why gameplay-wise meaningful changes are defined as at least 10 meters per second mean changes, as these are likely to have some real impact to the gameplay. Based on these definitions, the setups that would have a meaningful effect on gameplay are the fully upgraded upper frame internals, including the normal length precision barrel. A long inner barrel, here it is just the stock Armorer Works long barrel. The long barrel with Teflon tape seal, and finally, fully upgraded upper frame with a long precision barrel and an Airsoft Masterpiece slide and a Teflon tape seal. The normal length precision barrel with better chamber and bucking didn't meaningfully increase the gun power, but it led to very consistent values as the variation between shots reduced hugely. Finally, I would consider these parts just reinforced parts. Here they didn't boost the power, and I do not believe that they would decrease it either. The Sword 4.3 HI-CAPA has an inner barrel length of around 95 mm. The normal sized 5.1 has 112.5 mm, and here this Armorer Works wind velocity had a 166 mm length. Each centimeter increases the gun power and range. However, the stock Marui outer barrel needs to be replaced for proper attachment of a tracer or a silencer to hide the tip of the longer inner barrel. Here, the inner barrel is now 5.4 centimeters longer than previously, and only this, no other changes, increased the muzzle velocity by 14 meters per second. This is around a 16% boost to the gun power. The hop-up chamber and the bucking always leak slight amounts of air, which is wasted energy that could be potentially be directed to the BB. The idea of the Teflon tape is to create a better air seal around the tip of the bucking and theoretically increase the gun power. It also works in practice, because here the muzzle velocity with the long barrel was further increased with the Teflon tape seal, and this fulfills the criteria for the minimally detectable change. In a t-test of two independent samples, this difference was statistically significant, indicated by the low p-value. The Armorer Works standard barrel has a bore diameter of 6.03 mm. Here is the Armorer Works precision barrel with a 6.01 mm diameter in a maple leaf chamber. Before testing some power upgrade parts individually, here is the gold match with Airsoft Masterpiece slide, inside which all the internals are upgraded. The barrel is 166 mm Armorer Works precision barrel for the long HI-CAPA. And the maple leaf chamber and bucking here is sealed with the Teflon tape. And this time, otherwise fully upgraded gold match slide internals, but the barrel is the normal length precision barrel. The recoil spring and short stroke buffers should have no effect on the muzzle velocity. So, the maple leaf chamber doesn't seem to improve the gunpowder in this test. How could it be? Did I make a mistake? Others have also tested the impact on FPS, and from YouTube, the GBB enthusiast found that the combination of both maple leaf chamber plus precision barrel didn't increase the gunpowder. Therefore, I would consider the maple leaf chamber primarily as a reinforced part rather than a power part. Like already stated before, if you want a real power boost to the gun, just get a longer barrel, since the impact of a tighter barrel is usually quite small at best, and in this test it was not even detectable. I didn't test the accuracy at a shooting range, but in the tests previously conducted by GBB enthusiast, a maple leaf precision barrel of normal length didn't have a noticeable effect on accuracy. Using the minimally detectable difference criteria of 5 meters per second increase, this is a borderline case. However, notice the huge drop in standard deviation from 2.3 to 0.9, indicating that this combination of better chamber bucking and barrel really improves the shot-to-shot consistency. For the last testing, we have here the reinforced nozzle set made from injection molded polymer and an aluminium blowback housing. The nozzle is one of the commonest parts to break after heavy use, and this CowCow nozzle is made from more durable material than the Marui version. As far as I know, CowCow has two types of blowback housings, and this is the B02 model. Also, these provided to be mainly reinforced parts. Only installing these without any additional parts didn't materially improve the gun power in my testings, nor did they improve the shot-to-shot consistency. Thanks for watching, and I would hope some other players also to replicate these findings.